It's September, which means three things. Firstly, as a nation, we need to prepare for basic white girls countrywide to start their pilgrimage to the Temple of Pumpkin Spice. Secondly, we gotta remember to wake up that dude from Green Day at the end of the month. I forgot to do it last year, we gotta do it this year. And lastly, September means...
Haley, winter is coming.
So if you're like me, and you know what the winter is like, you're probably thinking, it's about time I get me some Quattro all-wheel drive. Audi didn't invent all-wheel drive, but you could argue that they perfected it. And they definitely have the resume to back that claim up.
The most amazing thing to me was we have an endless traction. The traction is with four-wheel drive, absolutely fantastic.
Mid clippers hit Winkelhock. Winkelhock pushed wide. Mid clip lead. Menu going through, is he? No. Winkelhock up.
Mehr, circa 600 insgesamt. Walter Röhrl geht jetzt das letzte Viertel des Berges an, während sein...
The original Audi Quattro was absolutely dominant in Group B Rally. And to pay its respects, Audi named its entire lineup of all-wheel drive vehicles after that legendary motorsports icon. But if you want to buy a car with Quattro all-wheel drive, things kind of start to get a little complicated, because there's five or more different types of Quattro all-wheel drive, and of course they all work differently. So which one of these systems is worth your time and money? Let's talk about that. When thinking about Audi's all-wheel drive system, the first way to start to understand and categorize the different systems that we're dealing with is to split the systems into the categories of transverse and longitudinal. Now, these terms aren't exclusive to Audi. They actually describe the layout of the engine and the drivetrain within your car, regardless of what brand it is. So this is generally good information to file in the back of your head somewhere. Now, if you open up your engine bay and the engine goes north-south, or the front of the engine is at the grill and the back of the engine is at the firewall or at the cabin part, that's what's called longitudinal. And if you open up the hood and the engine goes from east to west, or basically sideways in the engine bay, that is transverse. So knowing what type of drivetrain layout your Audi has is the first step to really understanding what type of Quattro system you're going to be dealing with. Like I mentioned before, there's like about five different types of Quattro. Two of these are transverse and three of them are longitudinal. And we'll talk about the transverse ones first. The first type of transverse Quattro system that we'll talk about is called a viscous coupling. Now, remember when I said that Audi systems are divided into transverse and longitudinal? Well, of course you do. That was exactly
27 seconds ago.
Well, that was kind of a lie, but that's not my fault. Chill out. That's not my fault. What just happened to you is, for the first time, you are experiencing
VW stuff.
A lot of the times with
VW stuff,
things are done in just kind of the most frustrating way possible, just for the sake of, I don't know, just being confusing. According to VW and Audi, the viscous coupling version of Quattro is primarily designed for VWs and has never been used in an Audi. Okay, so then why are we talking about it? Because, like I said,
VW stuff.
So while VW says that this viscous coupling all-wheel drive system is transverse and is not used by any Audis, if you look at what Audi has to say about it, they say that this version of Quattro is used exclusively on the R8, which is not transverse. It's a longitudinal engine layout. So lots of conflicting information flying around. But anyway, moving past the confusion of VW stuff here, despite what VW says, this is a longitudinal drivetrain setup. The only Audi that you'll find it in is the R8, and it has a 15 to 85 front rear split, meaning that when you're just driving around town, the R8 sends about 85% of its power to the rear and about 15% of its power to the front. The second type of transverse all-wheel drive system, or I guess the only type of transverse all-wheel drive system that you'll find on an Audi. Stop doing that, Volkswagen. So the only type of transverse all-wheel drive system that you'll find on an Audi is called Haldex. Now, Volkswagen and Audi, they are not responsible for developing holodecks. They actually buy it off the shelf from another company called BorgWarner. BorgWarner actually sells the same holodeck system to, obviously, other companies in the VW group, Ford, Volvo, and GM. As Paul from ShopDep says, holodecks is a faux-wheel drive system. Now, the reason why he says that is because the holodeck system is basically just front-wheel drive. The way holodecks works is that primarily most of your power is going to the front wheels, just like a front-wheel drive car. And then there is power that goes through a drive shaft to the rear, and the rear differential has a clutch. Once the computer deems that it's necessary to give you all-wheel drive or send some of that power to the rear, that clutch locks up and it sends power to the rear. But primarily, when you are driving around in a holodeck car, it is front-wheel drive until the car determines that you need power at the rear. So what's the big takeaway here? What you need to know about holodecks is that it is a reactive, not a predictive all-wheel drive system. And typically, when people are thinking about quattro all-wheel drive, what they are thinking about is a predictive or a full-time all-wheel drive system. And that is not what holodecks is. Now, that doesn't mean that holodecks is absolutely terrible. Cars like the RS3 and the Golf R use holodecks to great effect. And for the end user, there is actually a lot of benefit because it doesn't use as much fuel because you're not driving all four wheels all the time. Now, for our Audis that are longitudinal, there are three different possibilities that you will encounter in the wild. Now, most Audi enthusiasts will tell you if you are buying a car with longitudinal quattro, then you have nothing to worry about because it is real all-wheel drive. You don't have to worry about full-wheel drive up in here. But that's not entirely true, because holodecks isn't really the only type of reactive quattro system.
We have been hoodwinked, bamboozled, led astray, run amok, and flat out deceived.
Starting in about 2016, Audi started to offer a system called Quattro Ultra. And while Audi likes to call it Ultra, it is not the ultimate version of Quattro, in my opinion. And that's because what we are dealing with here is something that is similar to holodecks. Now, in their official literature, Audi goes out of their way to say that this is a proactive all-wheel drive system. It is not reactive like holodecks. But then if you listen to how they say it works and then also see how it works in real life, it's very similar to holodecks. So I'm just gonna go out on a limb here and call it reactive. Basically, if your car has Quattro Ultra, what is happening is your car is primarily front wheel drive. Sound familiar, right? Then through all of these sensors that the car is looking at, the car makes a determination of if you need to be able to shift power to the rear. When the car determines that, it uses a clutch to lock up, again, just like holodecks, and it sends power to the rear of the car. This system can only send 50% of the power to the rear. This is completely a limitation of how this system is designed. So basically, Quattro Ultra is, in my opinion, the longitudinal version of holodecks. It's front wheel drive in a lot of situations until it starts to shift that power to the rear. Now, just like with holodecks, that doesn't mean that everything here is terrible, because there are fuel economy savings to be had here, and the system actually weighs like 10 pounds less. But if what you were looking for is an Audi that drove all four wheels all the time, Quattro Ultra, even though the impressive name might lead you to believe it's the best version, probably isn't the product for you. Primarily, when a car enthusiast is talking about quattro all-wheel drive, what they are talking about is the Torsen all-wheel drive system. Now, from looking at the previous types of quattro, you probably are noticing a trend. A lot of different companies are involved with making this all-wheel drive system. Audi doesn't just create everything on their own. The Torsen center differential actually isn't designed and built by them. It's built by a company called, no surprise here, Torsen. A Torsen differential is not unique to Audi. You can actually buy one for pretty much any type of car. And it is a type of differential that some people might call a helical or a gear-based differential. But in technical terms, it is what is called an automatic torque biasing differential, or a ATB. Now, the name kind of explains exactly what it does. The differential can basically sense differences in the mechanical loading of each output shaft, and then it can automatically bias torque to the axle that has more traction. Now, this type of differential typically lives either in the front or the rear of most cars, and it's automatically biasing the torque between the left and right wheels based on which one has more traction. Now, how that works in an Audi isn't actually that much more complicated. They just turn everything 90 degrees. So instead of the differential biasing from left to right, it's biasing from front to rear. Now, most versions of Torsen have what is called a 2-to-1 differential, or that is what's called the bias ratio. What that means is, through the use of math, yes, I know everybody hates math, but I'll make this kind of simple to understand what's going on here. The Torsen differential uses what's called a bias ratio. Basically, whatever amount of grip is at the axle that has the least amount of grip, it automatically multiplies that torque by the bias ratio and sends it to the wheel that has the most traction. So for a 2-to-1 differential, it will automatically multiply by a 2-to-1 ratio. Now, this 2-to-1 torque biasing is exactly that. It is torque biasing once there is a loss of traction. It does not affect your static torque split. So when you are just driving around on the street, there's no loss of traction anywhere, that is your static torque split. So if your car is a 50-50 car, that is not being affected by if you have a 2-to-1 or a 4-to-1 differential. And that will be important in just a minute. So let's say we're driving down the road and we lose traction. How much torque can we transfer to the rear or the front of the car? Well, because we have a 2-to-1 torque bias ratio, the maximum that we can split either to the front or the rear is 66%. So basically, if we lose traction at the front of our Audi, the mechanics of the differential will send up to 66% of the torque to the rear. Or if we lose traction at the rear, it will send up to 66% up to the front. Now, there was an update to the Torsen differential in about 2007. The S4 got it, the RS4 got it, and then basically all Audis after that. So 2008 going forward, all Audis that are Torsen have the T3 differential. And this is a 4-to-1 differential. So what does that mean? Again, looking at our math, what that means is we can shift up to 80% to the rear or 80% to the front. All right, I'm back, interrupting myself for another Q-tip. If your car has a T2 differential, which is the 2-to-1 differential, and you want the 4-to-1 differential from a T3 car, there's actually a mod that you can do to give you that 4-to-1 biasing ratio. Now, where a lot of confusion comes in is that T3 cars typically have a static split of 40% in the front and 60% in the rear. So if you do the 4-to-1 mod to your T2 differential, it does not give you the 40-60 split. You are still 50-50 static split when you are driving around town without losing grip. All it does is it enhances the car's ability to be able to shift torque around. So you will get the ability to shift 80% to the rear or to the front, but you are still a 50-50 static split car. Now, this exact mod of going from a 2-to-1 to a 4-to-1 differential is exactly what I'm going to do to my transmission. If you've seen some of my previous videos, you probably have seen in the background, I have an 01E from a 2000 S4 that is going to go into my 2007 S4. When are we going to do that? There are way too many other projects going on around here, but when we do get to manual swapping the S4, we are going to do the 4-to-1 differential mod. And then there's one sneaky extra type of quattro that I didn't want to give its own category, but the Q7 technically has its own version of quattro, and it's shared with a whole bunch of different other VW heavy SUVs. So the Q7, Bentayga, Touareg, all of those very large SUVs share a all-wheel drive system that is designed by BorgWarner, but it uses a T3 differential. And most car enthusiasts aren't really out here trying to tear it up in a Q7. So I figured there wouldn't be too many people offended that I didn't do a deep dive into how the Q7's all-wheel drive system works. And then finally is the sixth generation of Quattro. Now, this version of Quattro ditches the torsion differential altogether and uses what they call a crown gear. It's very complicated for how it works, and it's well beyond the scope of this channel. But basically, what you will observe with this differential is that it has the same static split that you will find in the T3 setup, but the biasing is a little bit different because, well, it's not an automatic torque biasing differential. So when in action, the crown gear can send up to 70% of the torque to the front and 85% of the torque to the rear. So quite a bit different than how the torsion differential works. And then oftentimes this differential is paired with the Audi Sport rear differential. The reason for all of these changes is it allows for much better control of the drivetrain, and it allows the electronics of the car to better be able to determine where torque is being delivered and to better send torque to the wheel that has the most grip. This all-wheel drive system first appeared in about 2010, and then once Audi started to phase out the torsion system, basically what they did were, if it wasn't a performance-oriented car, it got Quattro Ultra, which, again, I want to call four-wheel drive. So if it was a performance model, so like an S4, S7, RS4, it then got the crown gear center differential. So I just said a whole bunch of words at you guys. What's the big takeaway? Well, if you're looking at an Audi that is front wheel drive based or has a transverse engine layout, that is a Haldex car. And while that isn't terrible, it's not a permanent all-wheel drive system. It's basically all-wheel drive on demand or four-wheel drive. Now, if you're looking at an Audi that is longitudinal based and it's not the R8, you are dealing with one of three different types of all-wheel drive systems. Me personally, I would avoid the cars that have Quattro Ultra. I live in a place where it snows quite dramatically and the snow gets really deep, so I prefer having permanent all-wheel drive. But if you are okay with the idea of your all-wheel drive Audi not being all-wheel drive all the time, then Quattro Ultra probably will work for you. Now, if you're like me and you demand to have all four wheels all the time, you really have two options. If it's an older Audi, you more than likely are dealing with a torsion-based all-wheel drive system, which personally is my favorite because we all know I can't afford a new car, so. And if you're looking at a newer Audi, what you're looking at is a crown gear all-wheel drive system. Both of these systems are phenomenal, and, well, you never really have to worry about being stuck anywhere. So that's pretty much all that I have for you guys. I will see you guys in the next video.